broken nose don't mean nothing. Tell Booker be ready.
So if the ghost gorilla wants to fight him, they can get the ghost in there with Tell Brooke. I'll pay to see that. Manny Pacquiao is irrelevant in the sport of boxing right now. The only thing that's relevant with him is Floyd Mayweather. Other than that, Manny Pacquiao is irrelevant. He's not going to fight anybody that's of any interest to anybody in the world. He's going to either fight Marquez or he's going to fight Mayweather, and that's it. Nobody really cares about him in the mix.
He talked about how he went with Manny Pacquiao, and so much of a fight, but that's never gonna happen.
But you gotta look at the Aiden situation. Aiden has been avoided by everybody at 147. They would pay him money rather than get in the ring. That's why Don King bought half of his contract from Ahmed Ahmed, because they know they got a killer. And I knew that going into that fight, that the Ghost Gorilla cannot stand up with a guy like that. That's why they put him in that 50 by 50 ring. They railroaded him all the way down to the last second, and they was okay with it, because they knew Aiden could get him out of there. Now, I don't know what's going on. He might got diabetes or something. He needs to get evaluated. If he's seeing double vision like that early on, he must have got some type of diabetic thing going on. They should detect that right away. But I think Aiden can beat Andre Berto. I knew he was going to beat Berto. When Berto was undefeated, they ducked him and they paid him that step-aside money. So they can go ahead and do the Ortiz fight. I said, yep, he dodged the bullet. And we know Ortiz is going to get in the business. And then Victor Ortiz and Mayweather, he wanted to fight Mayweather, of course, so they had to come up with that cause, that loophole thing, so they can get past Aiden again. But this guy has been the number one contender for a reason. No one wants to fight him. They said, oh, well, you can box him all night long, but you got to be able to deal with that power. Everybody has said that. And that's why he was undefeated all the way up there. So they thought they could stay away from him. But when he cuts the ring off on him, and he's not that slow. The Ghost did a lot of good things yesterday to save his life. He took advantage of the ring when he needed it, because he knew he had all the space in the world to work. Like I said, I don't think his back touched the ropes. Yeah, he was smart. And then you knew they were going to work the cancer story in. The cancer story me to death. And they interviewed his wife at the end. I was like, Showtime milked him more than HBO.
Yeah,
they
don't
have to do it. Yeah, I guess so. You got to have a story. And they ran with that. And I thought the story, the fight was good enough. And it didn't really need a story no more. You know, let's focus on the fight. They were so interested in the story and Robert the Ghost Gorilla winning. Golden Boy made sure they took care of every aspect of this one. They could not have a Victor Ortiz situation. Yep, they gave every advantage. It's gonna be in your hometown. All the judges gonna be on your side. All you got to do is make it 12 rounds, girl. Can you do it? But where does he go from here? Where does Tim Bradley go from here? You talking about somebody that fell into obscurity? Tim Bradley. They talking about he's a candidate for 154, Miguel Cotto. Yeah, they talking about he's a candidate. Tim Bradley? A candidate? I don't see it. Now, what is he going to be a candidate of? He can barely make it. I mean, at 147, he really doesn't have the power, even at 147. So, I don't know where you're going to go with this.